Hello, this is Andrew Klein. This is the third video series in my Principles of 3D Modeling set of videos. In the first two videos, we looked at creating some very basic forms using polygon models. And in the first video itself, we looked at using polygon cubes to create a simple chair from a reference image. In the second video, we looked at using actually NURBS geometry and polygon geometry to create a toy, again, based on reference. In both of those two cases, however, I was looking at an image and trying to compare between the model that I was making in 3D and the actual image that I had open in a separate image viewer program. Well, this doesn't take full advantage of Maya's functionality, and that's one of the things we're going to work at in this third video series, which is building an airplane using a polygon box modeling method. Now, to produce this airplane, I've actually downloaded a set of orthographic images. They're essentially blueprints of this airplane you see here, which is the Arsenal VG-33. You can find lots of blueprints of aircraft and spacecraft type things all over the internet, and there are plenty of sites to actually find images just like this. I've chosen this airplane for the purpose of this tutorial because it is sort of a somewhat simpler design, but it has all the necessary features we need to talk about for this tutorial. Very interestingly, it has wings, of course, front and back wings, a rounded fuselage, and also a propeller up front, which is going to be interesting to add in. What I want to do with these blueprints is I want to actually put them in Maya so that I can draw right on top of them. Now, when working with image planes inside of Maya, I don't want us to get confused with some of the terminology that I'm going to be using today. We are building an airplane. What you see on the screen is going to be image planes depicting an airplane. We might also be using polygon planes to help model the form, so don't get confused with the three different usages of the word plane throughout this. Now, looking at what I've got started, I have a black and white image, and you'll actually notice in the very top line that my image is actually a grayscale 8-bit image. Now, this could actually pose some problems for me when I import this into Maya. Maya prefers RGB 8-bit images, and even though this doesn't have any color to it, it's just black and white, we want to convert this to be RGB 8-bit. So we've got this image open and loaded inside Photoshop, and I'm going to go to Image and choose Mode, and from the drop-down menu, switch this from grayscale to RGB, and I'll leave my bit depth at 8-bit. Well, one of the other things that I like to work on when setting these up is that if I have a high contrast black and white image that goes into Maya, it sometimes becomes very hard to work on top of that image. So what I like to do is actually gray this out a little bit. That'll really tone down the contrast of this image and help me see on top of what I'm doing a little bit easier. So I'm going to go to Image, Adjustments, and choose Levels, or use the hotkey Control L. You can actually see from my Levels slider, I'm all in the black and all on the white, and there's really nothing in between, which is going to be not too helpful for me. Using the bottom slider, which goes from black to white as a gradient, I can actually push these values closer towards the middle, taking the black and making it more gray, and taking the white and making that more gray. And if I clamp this into a more of a medium gray range, it's going to be much easier to work on top of when I get inside of Maya. So I'll hit OK, and there we go. Now, a couple of things that you're going to want to see when you're actually putting together your image planes and setting them up for Maya. First of all, the orientation that you see here in this image is absolutely correct. And this just goes to show, and we're going to see this when we go back inside of Maya, you have to be really on top of which direction the image of your airplane is pointing. In the last two tutorials in this series, I made it very clear that you want your Z-axis facing towards the screen your x-axis going from side to side, planar with the screen, and your y-axis going up and down. Essentially, I want my nose of my airplane to be pointing forward in the z-axis. And you'll find that that is the case if we have our nose pointing forward, like you see here, and our nose pointing to the left, as you see in this airplane on top. So if our side view points to the left, if our top view points down, and if our front view points forward, we're going to be quite all right. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to crop this image into three separate images so that I can use it inside of Maya. I'm going to switch to the crop tool in the toolbox. That's the third tool down on the left side of the toolbox inside Photoshop. And I'm just going to drag the selection over the top airplane. And you know what? I'm actually not going to be modeling the landing gear, so I'm going to cut this just above the landing gear there. And when it's got its selection, just hit enter. And I've got an airplane. Let me go ahead and choose File, Save As. And if I just find the location which I want to save this, I should be fine. Now I'm going to have a folder called Airplane that I've already established on my desktop. We're going to go inside of there, and I'm going to save this as a JPEG, and I'm going to call this side.jpg. Well, I want to get the other two, so I'm going to go back to my history, go back to the previous operation, which was levels, and now just choose a crop box over the middle airplane, that's the top view, and hit enter. And let's save this as top.jpg. And again, I'll hit Control Z or go back in my history to the previous action. And once again, crop the bottom airplane. And this is the front view. So I will call this front and hit save. And now I've got three airplanes which to work with. So that has been our first video. We're going to close out of Photoshop. And in the next video, we're actually going to take a look at our settings inside of Maya. Thanks.